school year, we do outreach programs in schools, and that got started in Pittsburgh with a group called Gateway to the Arts, and they helped us develop a program, an interactive program, and that was maybe when we were first getting started, about 10 years ago, and since then, it's expanded. We work with a group called Artivate in the Maryland and DC area, and young audiences of New Jersey and Eastern Pennsylvania. And they both have the same mission, just to bring the arts to schools.
One of the highlights, though, is during the summer, we run in a pretty intensive camp for cellos, violas, violins, and basses. And it's a way that we get the kids to kind of come out of their shell musically, and they get to experiment and play lots of out of the ordinary music than they normally would in a school orchestra setting. We let them pick some of their music, and then Ben and I and Cole sometimes will help us arrange music for the kids, and we have them 9 to 4 for an entire week, and we're able to put together a concert in only 5 days, and that's really a challenge, but it's also a lot of fun. It always pays off, and we somehow always pull it off, and we do this 4 times every summer, so it's pretty cool experience.
In addition to the summer camp that we hold every summer and the school outreach programs that we do throughout the year, we're each very much involved with our private teaching. And in addition to the fundamental classical training and the traditional classical repertoire, we try and show our students from very early on what you can really do with the instrument.
For me, giving back through our music performances is really important because that's how I got inspired to pick up the cello. It was through a group of high school kids who came to my school and played for me, and I thought, wow, the cello is so awesome.
Students usually love it because we have long flowing hair and we get to
headbanging,
have really fast songs with drums, and so it's pretty like sucks you in, and then the teachers usually respond really well too. Mm-hmm.
We're always getting feedback from the schools that we visit, and so many times we've heard that there's just been this severe influx of new cellists after we show up because all the kids are just like all of a sudden, wow, that didn't know that that could be, you know, from a, you know, fourth or fifth grader standpoint, that could be cool. It's also really nice to see that, you know, the cellists that do exist in the school before we get there, and you know, they come up and talk to us, and then we hear that all of a sudden this person's like the coolest kid in school because we showed up. And it's really nice because personally, I remember when I was in, you know, fifth grade and I was carrying around the cello that was bigger than I was, and I was not the cool kid, and it's no matter what, it's for kids, it's important that if they have whatever creative outlet they've chosen, that it's reinforced, and to see what kind of impact we have on that is just really special for us.
I think our yearly average, we get to perform for maybe 15 to 20,000 kids every year, which is pretty cool when you look at all the stats. We just try to get kids excited to join their music programs, and if they play already, to keep it up, and try to let them know that once you learn your classical music, you can branch out and reach lots of different possibilities.